Very good morning, children. Sai Ram. So welcome back to our online Max class. Okay, so today we are going to learn a new chapter. Okay, in the previous class we have finished the chapter, isn't it? So today we are going to start a new chapter, chapter number 8, fractions. Okay, what is the title of the chapter? Fractions. So you have learnt this in the previous year itself, isn't it? So can you remember what is meant by fraction? Can you remember? Yes, we'll see. What is fraction? A fraction is a part of a whole or a collection. Okay, a fraction is a part of a whole or a collection. Okay, how do we represent? So we represent a fraction like this. Okay, so the number written above this line is called numerator. Okay, the number written above this line is called numerator, and the number written below this line is called denominator. Okay, the number written below that line is called denominator. Okay, so how do we name this fraction? So in this fraction, what is numerator? One is the numerator and three is the denominator. Okay, then how do we name this fraction? So we can say this fraction by telling one the name, that is first we say the numerator followed by the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay, so how do we name them? So we name a fraction by first saying the numerator followed by the ordinal name of the denominator. So what is the ordinal name for 3? It's third, isn't it? Third. Then how do we name this fraction? It is 1/3. Okay, it is 1/3. For example, 1/3 is read as 1/3. Okay, ordinal name. Okay, how do we name the fraction? By saying the numerator followed by the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay, so if the numerator is greater than 1, then we have to add s to the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay, here the numerator, in this example 1/3, the numerator is 1, so we say that 1/3. But if the numerator is greater than 1, for example consider this fraction, then how do we name this? 2/5. We have to add s to the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay, not 2/5, just 2/5. Okay, so if the numerator is greater than 1, then we have to add s to the ordinal name of the denominator. Okay, then how do we find the fraction value of the whole? We have to divide by the given number of the whole. Okay, we have to divide the whole by the given number. That is, for example, to find 1/2 of a whole or a collection, what we have to do? We have to divide the whole by 2. because in the denominator we have 2, isn't it? So we have to divide the whole by 2. Okay, so how to find the fraction of a whole value? So we have to divide the whole by this number, whatever the number they have given in the denominator. Okay, yes, so shall we do some examples? Yes, first example, color the figures to show the given fractions. Color the figures to show the given fractions. But before going that, we should learn. So in the fraction we have written, so consider this fraction 1 by 4. So what is 1? It is number of parts selected. Okay, so how does the fraction will be made? Number of parts selected divided by total number of equal parts of the whole. Okay, so number of parts selected by divided by total number of equal parts of the whole. Okay, so in this example 1 by 4, so 1 is the number of parts selected, so 4 is the total number of equal parts of the whole. So out of 4 parts, one part should be selected. Okay, that is the meaning. Okay, so out of 4 parts, one part should be selected. Okay, so shall we do these examples now? Yes. So color the figures to show the given fractions. First one, 1 by 4. 1 by 4. So out of this, so what is 1? Number of parts selected. What is 4? Total number of parts, isn't it? So here there are 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts we have, isn't it? We are having 4 parts. So out of 4 parts, how many parts should be shaded? Only 1 part, isn't it? So shall we do? So out of 4 parts, 1 part should be shaded. Okay, so this 1 part. Is it clear, children? Yes. So the next example, B, 4 by 6. 4 by 6. So the number of parts is, total number of parts is 6. Okay. So out of 6 parts, how many parts should be shaded? 4, isn't it? 4 is the number of parts selected. So number of parts selected by total number of equal parts. Note this, underline the word equal. Okay, the word equal is very important. Okay, total number of equal parts of the whole. So out of 6 parts, we have to color 4 parts. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So we shall color these 4 parts. Okay, yes, so we have colored 4 parts out of 6 parts. Is it clear? Yes. So the next one, C, 3 by 6. 3 by 6. So number of parts selected is 3 total number of parts is 6. So out of 6, we are going to color 3 parts. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. Okay. So we shall color these 3 parts. Yes. So you can color it neatly, children. I cannot color neatly here. Okay, so you can color it neatly in your textbook. Okay, have you all understood? Yes. So what is fraction? Fraction is a part of a whole or a collection. So how do we write that fraction? Number of parts selected divided by total number of equal parts of the whole. Okay. So the next one, write the fraction shown by the shaded part. So they have given the shaded picture. For that, we are going to write the fractions. Okay. In the previous example, for the given fraction, we have shaded the figure. But now they have given the shaded picture. For that, we are going to write the fraction, correct fraction. Okay, shall we write? Yes. First one, A. So now first we shall find the total number of equal parts of the whole. Okay, and that should be written. That should be the denominator. Okay, that will be the denominator. Okay, total number of equal parts of the whole. That will be the denominator. So, shall we count? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, what is the denominator? 8. So out of 8 parts, how many parts they have shaded? Shall we count? 1, 2, 3. So they have shaded 3 parts. So the number of parts selected, that will be the numerator. So 3 should be written in the numerator. So the fraction is 3/8. 3/8. Okay, next B1. So now we shall count the total number of equal parts of the whole. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the total number of equal parts of the whole, that will be the denominator. Denominator is 12. Okay. What is numerator? Number of parts selected. Here, number of parts shaded. Okay. Shall we count? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is 6? So 6 will be the numerator. So the fraction is 6/12. Okay, 6/12. That is 6/12. Okay, next one C. So first let's find out the denominator. Okay, total number of equal parts of the whole. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So what is the denominator? 9. And the numerator is number of parts selected. Okay, here number of parts shaded. Okay, so count 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many parts they have shaded? 4. So that will be the numerator. So the fraction is 4/9. Okay, is it clear? Have you all understood? Yes. Next one, find 1/2 of 16. So just now we have learnt how to find the fraction of a whole value. So we have to divide the whole by the fraction. Okay. So first one, 1/2 of 16. So we have to divide the 16. 16 is a whole number. So we have to divide the 16 by 2. Okay. So 16 divided by 2. How many times? 8 twos are 16. So the answer is 8. Okay. The next one, 1/3 of 51. 1/3 of 51. So how to find? So we have to divide 51 by 3. Okay. 51 divided by 3. So 1 threes are 3. Subtract 21. And 7 threes are 21. So the answer is 17. Okay. And C, 1/4 of 48. 1/4 of 48. So we have to divide 48 by 4. So 1/4s are 4. Subtract 0 and bring down this 8. 2/4s are 8. Subtract 0. So the answer is 12. So 1/4 of 48 is 12. Okay. And D sum is 1/4 of a score. 1/4 of a score. Score means 20. Okay. Score means 20. So we have to divide 20. Okay. 20 by 4. So how many times? 5 times. 5 fours are 20. So the answer is 5 here. Okay. And now E sum 1/2 of a year in months. So 1/2 of a year in months. So how many months in a year? There are 12 months in a year, isn't it? So whole is 12. Okay, so we have to divide 12 by 2. How many times? 6 times. 6 twos are 12. So the answer is 6. So we have to say it in months. So how many months? 6 months. Okay, how many months? 6 months. The last sum F, 1/2 of April in days. 1/2 of April. So how many days in April month? How many days are there in April month? So there are 30 days in April month. Okay, how many days? 30 days. Okay, 30 days. So we have to divide 30 by 2. Okay, 30 by 2. So 1 twos are 2. Subtract 3 minus 2 is 1. And bring down the 0. 5 twos are 10. So subtract 0. So how many days? 15 days. Okay, how many days? 15 days. So have you all understood how to find the fraction of a whole value? So we have to divide the whole by the given fraction. Okay. Have you all understood, children? Yes. So next we are going to learn about equivalent fractions. Okay. Equivalent fractions. So fractions that have the same value or represent the same part of a whole are called equivalent fractions. Okay. What are equivalent fractions? Fractions that have the same value or represent the same part of a whole are called equivalent fractions. So we'll see one example. So here, so out of two parts, there are two parts, so they have written two in the denominator and one part is selected, so they have written one. Okay, and what is this fraction? So there are four parts, so they have written four in the denominator. Out of four, they have shaded two parts, so they have written two in the numerator. Okay, so in here in the third figure, there are 3, 4, 5, 6. There are six parts, so they have written six in the denominator. And how many parts they have shaded? 1, 2, 3, isn't it? So they have written three in the numerator. Number of parts selected. Okay, so in the last figure, how many parts? The total number of parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total number of parts, that is denominator, so they have written 8 in the denominator. And how many parts they have shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4. That is number of parts selected, isn't it? So they have written 4 in the numerator. Okay, so these all fractions are equivalent fractions. How? Because all these figures represent the half of the circle shaded, isn't it? Look at the shaded part of the circles in all the figures. It is a semicircle, isn't it? So the shaded part of the circle are equal. Okay, so similarly, look at the fractions. First one is 1 by 2. And the second one is 1 into 2, 2 into 2. So 1 2's are 2, 2 2's are 4. That will be the second fraction. Okay. The third one is 1 into 3. 1 3's are 3, 2 3's are 6. So that will be the third fraction. And fourth is 1 4s are 4, 2 4s are 8. Okay, so all these figures represent the same part of shaded circle, isn't it? So they all are equivalent fractions. Okay, have you all understood? Yes. So what are equivalent fractions? Fractions that have the same value or represent the same part of a whole are called equivalent fractions. Okay. So we'll do the exercise problems. Okay. So exercise 8.1. Represent 1 by 2 in three different ways and write the fraction for each. Represent 1 by 2 in three different ways and write the fraction of 4 each. So first figure they have given 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Say, so there are total number of parts is 2. So out of 2 parts they have shaded 1 part. Isn't it? So they have written 1 by 2. So how do we write? So there are 4 parts here. How? 2 2's are 4. In the denominator, 2 2's are 4. And we have to multiply in the numerator also. So 2 by 4. So out of 4 parts, we have to color. First we'll write the fractions for all of these. Okay. So 2 by 4. Okay, and they have divided this into 6 equal parts, isn't it? They have divided this rectangle into 6 equal parts. Here 4 and here 6. So 6 will be the denominator, and what will be the numerator? 2 threes are 6. Now 1 threes are 3. Okay, and what will be the next one? Total number of parts is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 parts. So 4 twos are 8 and 1 fours are 4. Okay, so now we shall color. So we have to color 2 parts out of 4 parts, isn't it? So we shall color these 2 parts. Okay, is it right? Is it correct? Yes. So in this figure, out of 6 parts, we are going to color 3 parts. Okay, so we shall color these 3 parts. Okay, so color these 3 parts. So you can color neatly in your textbook. Okay, so in the last fraction, so how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 parts are there. So out of 10, so how do we get that 10? So 2 into 5. And 1 into 5. So 1 5s are 5. So here 5 by 10. Okay, 5 by 10. So out of 10 parts, we are going to color 5 parts. Okay, children. So does 5 by 10. Okay, so out of 10 parts, we are going to color 5 parts. So we shall color 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These 5 parts. Okay. So these 5 parts I have colored. Okay, 5 by 10. Okay, so these are all equivalent fractions. So we have represented 1 by 2 in 3 different ways, and we have written the fractions also. Okay, children, have you all understood? Yes. So now we are going to represent 2 by 3 in 3 different ways, and we are going to write the fractions for each. Okay, now we are going to represent 2 by 3. Fraction 2 by 3. So first we will write the fractions, okay, and then we'll color. Okay, so first 2 by 3, because there are 3 parts, isn't it? So 3 out of 3, we are going to color 2 parts. Okay, and here how many parts are there? 6 parts are there. So total number of parts is 6. So 3 twos are 6. So in the numerator, so we are going to multiply 2 to the numerator. Okay, 2 twos are 4. 4 by 6. So out of 6 parts, we are going to color 4 parts. Okay, the last figure, big figure, the total parts is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So there are 9 equal parts. Okay, how we get this 9? 3 threes are 9, isn't it? 3 threes are 9. So multiply this numerator by 3. So 2 threes are 6. So out of this 9 parts, we are going to color 6 parts. Okay. So on the first figure, out of 3, we are going to color 2. So first 2 we shall color. Okay. Okay. The next figure, out of 6 parts, we are going to color 4 parts. Okay. So first 1, 2, 3, 4. So we shall color these 4 parts. Yes. The next one, out of 9 parts, we are going to color 6 parts. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So shall we color these 6 parts? Yes. So we have colored and we have written the fractions also. Okay. Is it clear, children? How do we write these equivalent fractions? So they have given 6. Total number of parts is 6. How do we get this 6? 3 threes are 6. So we have to multiply this numerator by 2. Okay, so 2 twos are 4. And here 3 threes are 9. So multiply this numerator by 3. So 2 threes are 6. Okay. Have you all understood? And depending upon the fractions, we have shaded the picture. Okay. So do it carefully and neatly in your textbook. Okay, children. So read well, study well. Okay. Thank you.